Hi, this is Mike with Backroads Vanner, and today I'm going to show you my canopy system. I've had this canopy system for probably 5 or 6 years now, and every time I set it up, no matter whether I'm at a music festival or a van festival, people ask me about this canopy system. So I decided today to shoot a video and show you how this canopy system works. Stick around and check out this video. This canopy system is a 15 by 15. It comes out 15 feet this way and 15 feet long, so it's perfect for the size of your van. One of the things that I did was I made it go over the van. And the purpose of that is, we live down here in Texas, and camping any place, shade is always the first thing to go. Anybody that's camping is always looking for the shady spots. So by putting a shade over this van, we can camp out in the middle of anywhere and still have shade, so it works out well for us. The other thing is I made the pitch on this very steep. A lot of canopy systems, when they get rain and wet, they sag in the middle. And this canopy system has a support right here in the middle, and this is very tight, and it has such a great pitch on it that it never holds water. All your water runs off. The other thing is if you're camping and it starts raining, instead of ruining your fun, this, you got plenty of room to stay in here and stay dry, but it runs the water, it sheds the water to that side of the van, and sheds the water about 10 or 12 feet out on this side of the van. So it keeps your campsite dry. I've had driving rains and winds before coming from one direction or the other, and I was able to hang another tarp right here and block off all the wind coming from the side, and it made it very comfortable in here. I was camping up on top of a mountain in Arkansas. I was there for a 4 or 5 day music festival, and a tornado came and hit about 2 miles away, and it completely devastated all the easy ups, all the tents, and all the other gear that most people had. And this withstood the high winds of, I don't know, probably 60 or 70, 80 miles an hour winds. And one of the reasons this withstands the high winds is because it allows the wind to go through it. It doesn't catch the wind. So the wind can come through it this way, or it can come through it this way. And these bungee cords that are on here keep tension on this tarp at all times and keep it taut. The one thing that I don't have on the awning system right now that I use is a tie-down system. And I have screw into the ground things that have a spring and a strap, and it puts a lot of weight down on this and pulls this side down, and it keeps this part of it tight and sturdy to the ground, and that allows it to. Right now where we're camping, there's no wind and no need for it. We're just using it for shade right now. One of the things that I like about this canopy system compared to other canopy systems that I've seen out there is that a lot of canopies are attached right here on your van. And when you go to open this door, it hits the canopy and it doesn't give you the clearance and the room that you need. And by the time that canopy comes out this way with a pitch, it's very low. You'd have to duck to get underneath it. I made these out of PVC pipe and a T, and I raised that up. And you can set this height to whatever you want, but I thought that was a great height there. I could still haul my canoe and my kayak on top, and still I do have my kayak over there on the back, and I can still set my canopy system up without removing the kayak or the canoe. But I wanted to raise this high enough so that I could still use my fantastic fan in the back and open that up. And if I had things on top of here, it would still work with that. But this is a great height, and it's a great pitch coming off of here. And like I said, it allows the doors to open up. It allows a lot of airflow to come through here. One of the problems that when I looked at some of the other canopy systems is their expense. They were quite expensive to buy an awning system that came across here. You could buy a freestanding one, but the problem that I ran into with some of them is they weren't big enough to get a van under, and if you could get your van underneath it, you didn't have any room for a porch or covering on the side of the van. So this is kind of a modification, and I bought this canopy. It's a 15 by 15 canopy, and I bought it online, and it was very inexpensive, and then I built this framework all around it using an old Shelter Logic canopy system that I had. And I did have to purchase a few poles, a couple from Home Depot. They were very inexpensive. And some PVC pipe is basically all I used, and some bungee cords. and it turned into a great canopy system. The height of this is adjustable, and also the size of this. This tarp, I just got a 15 by 15 because I wanted plenty big enough for the side of the van. But if you wanted something smaller, you could get a 15 by 10 or even a 10 by 10. I developed another canopy system that's very similar to this, and it uses the same pieces. Almost everything is identical, only it goes off the back of the van. And all you do is you take this PVC pipe and you turn it this way and run your pipes long ways. And I use it right here from here on back, and it extends 10 feet off the back of the van as well. So if you're doing most of your food prep or you're camping out of the back of your van, that's an option too, that you can turn the whole thing. This is the one that I use the most because I'm usually getting in and out of the side here. I usually have my lawn chairs, my table, and everything set up here. And this is where I want the rain protection. This is where I want the shade. And once again, it shades the whole van, runs all the rain off to that side, and runs the rain off to this side. If you ever ripped your tarp or decided you wanted a different color or something like that, they're very inexpensive. You're not buying a high dollar canopy that might be one of those $800,000 ones that you attach to the side here. Those would be very expensive to replace. This one here is very inexpensive. Matter of fact, when I got this one, I ordered 4 or 5 of them, just in different sizes for the different setups, and they're very, very inexpensive, and they're very durable as well. This canopy system was based off of my ladder rack. Since this was a work van that I had for many years, I already had the ladder rack. And so when I was looking at a canopy system for this, it was only natural to use the ladder rack that I have. I can't remember the cost of these because I've had these for years and years, but they're weather guard, and they are very strong and very durable, and they come in handy for a lot of things. For one, I'm hauling my kayak on it now. I've hauled long pieces of pipe and different things like that, but you could use a platform, make it into a platform, and still be able to utilize this type of awning system. So since I already had the ladder rack, it was very easy to buy some PVC pipe, use a current canopy that I had from Shelter Logic, and just buy a inexpensive tarp, and the whole thing came together relatively inexpensive. My guess would be, if you were to buy this entire thing completely brand new, everything from the Shelter Logic to the tarp to the ladder rack and everything brand new would probably cost you around $800. So even so, if it costs you $800 to buy everything brand new, to buy the awning systems that they have that are attached to the van that aren't near as durable or as sturdy as something like this, it's probably going to be comparable in price, or maybe even less expensive to go this route. And in my opinion, this is a far superior canopy system for your van. There are two downsides to it. Everything's got its downside. This one here, when you park your van, you're stuck. You can't just pull your van out and run to go buy some ice and run to the store for something. That's okay with me, because normally when I set this up, I'm camped someplace for 2 or 3 days, or I'm camped at a music festival for a longer period of time, or I've gotten pretty good at tearing this thing down and setting it up. It takes maybe 20 minutes to do. It's a lot easier to do if you have another helper, but one person can do it, and you become very efficient at it. So I don't mind setting it up, but the downside of it is once you've set it up, you can't just take your van and just drive off and come back. So that is the downside to it, but it's, like I said, it's a very great canopy system. Keeps the van nice and cool, and gives you plenty of shade. The other downside to this canopy system is you have to take one extra piece of equipment with you, and that is a ladder. When I first developed this, I used to take my stepladder with me, and I would just attach it to the top, and it was no big deal. Easy to get on, easy to get off, and use to set this up. Since then, I bought a collapsible ladder, and this is great. I do use this a lot for getting the kayak on and off, and it just extends like this and retracts like that. So it's worth getting one of these for the canopy system. It stores very easy, it's light, and it's takes up very little room. So I use that. But anyhow, that's the downside to the canopy system. Thank you for watching. Check out the video. I'm going to time lapse it and show you how fast and easy it goes up and how fast and easy it goes down. Thanks for watching. Got my rug that I'll set up. and this is my custom awning. So give me a second to set my rug up, and then I'll put the awning together and we'll go from there. As I've made these, taking just some cheap plastic PVC pipe, which is inexpensive, and I added some tees to the top. And these will slide right down over the ladder rack, as you'll see in just a minute, and allow the pipes and all the awning to go with this. And it's a very quick and very fast setup just by putting these in place. So I'll show you that. There you go. I think that's it. Already I'm missing my shade. Wow, it warms up fast when you don't have the shade. But hope you've enjoyed this video, and if you have any questions, check us out on backroadsvanner.com, and I'll be happy to answer any of your questions. See you on down the road.